Okay. Good morning, class. Today we start our next important topic, that is a gradient descent. Okay. So in this coming lecture, we must understand what is that a gradient descent, where we use the gradient descent, why we use the gradient descent, okay, and how it is helpful in the regression, linear regression, logistic regression, and clustering concept. Okay. So first, before we start the gradient descent, let us understand more about the gradient descent. So let us consider you are the blindfold man who want to climb to the top of the hill with a serious step along with a weight as possible. He might start climbing the hill by taking really big steps in steadfast direction, which he can do as long as he is not close to the top. So what we have to do here, there is a one blindfolded man and he wants to climb on the top of the hill. So how it can be performed? So first he has to take the maximum step, okay, bigger step, so that he can climb on the hill. And once he reached to the top of the, or close to the top, so he can take a small step. So this is very natural thing we can do also when we are when we climb on the hill. Okay. So in this case, real life also, when you want to climb on the hill, so you have to take a long step to reach on the top. And once you come near the top or close to the top, your step direction or step will be in small. As you come closer to the top, however, this step will get smaller and smaller to avoid the overshooting it. And this process can be described mathematically using the gradient descent. So from this concept, the gradient descent is inspired. Okay, so you can also implement this concept by in your real life if you visit to a hill station, and then you want to climb on the hill. Okay, so how we can mathematically prove that? So let us consider this. This is an image of top down view. Okay, so this is indicating the top view of your you can say that this is a top view. Okay, so this is a top view of your hill. So this is the topmost position and this is a ground level. Okay, this is at the ground level. So you have to start from this position. Let us consider you are here. Okay, and now you want to climb on this hill. So how we can do it? So when you want to climb on this hill, so you have to use the gradient descent. How we can use this gradient descent? So let's understand it first. Okay, before it, let's illustrate this figure image, that this is the top. Okay, of the hill. Okay, and this is the bottom side. Okay, this is the bottom. Okay, so this is the bottom. From the bottom, you have to start and up to the top of the hill. Right? So this is sort of the this is the condition. Now we have to understand how it is mathematically proved the gradient descent. So think of gradient in this context as a vector that contain the direction of the steps in blindfold man and can take how long that step should be. Okay, so you can look at that from this diagram. The gradient ranging from x0 to x1 is much more than the X3 and the X4. Why? Because at this lower side you have to take a big step as compared to the at the closer you have to take a small step. Okay. So you can think, you can say that the gradient ranging from X0 to X1. So this is the X0 and this is the X1 is larger, longer than the reaching from X3 to X4. This is because the steepness or slope of the hill which determine the length of vector is less. This perfectly represents the example of hill because the hill is getting the less steep at the higher and when it is climbed. Therefore, reduce the gradient goes along with reduce the slope and reduce the step size of the hill climber. Okay, so this is a this is a real life example, and we want to now implement this real life example using the gradient descent using the mathematical operation. So what exactly mean by the gradient descent? So as per the definition, the gradient descent is an optimized algorithm for finding a local minimum of a differential function. So here we have used the differential function to finding out the local minimum. The gradient descent is simply used to find the value of function parameter, that is we can say that a coefficient that minimize the cost function as far as possible. Okay. So in this gradient measure how much the output of a function change if you change the input a little bit. Okay, so let us consider there is one algorithm and in that algorithm we are providing the input value and the output value. Okay, so when you providing an input value your output should be changed obviously. So let us consider weight versus height. Okay, so in the case of the weight versus height you are providing the height of a person and your output will be the weight. So when you change the height of a person, so how much your output, that is weight of a person, is get changed? How we can find out that? So for to measure this thing, we are use the gradient descent. Okay. So this gradient descent is very useful in the condition in a regression or the in a logistic regression and simple linear regression. So let us consider this is your weight and this is your height. Okay. So as soon as you are changing the, obviously you are changing the height of a person, your weight is also get changed. Okay, so if your height is 4.5, so your weight must be 39 kg. If your height is 6 feet, so your weight must be 81 kg and so on. So the question is that how your output, that is this is your output. Okay, weight is your output and the height is your input. So when you are providing the height, obviously your weight must be get changed. And the question is that how much time or how much your weight has been changed when you change the input, that is your weight. So this is your input and this is your output. But when I change the input, how much your output is get changed? And to finding out this correlation is nothing but the gradient measure. Okay, so in this case we have to measure the gradient, that how much output of a function change if you change the input a little bit. Okay, so this is called a gradient descent. So what is the gradient descent? The gradient descent is nothing but the optimized algorithm which is used to finding out the minimum, local minimum of differential function, and it is used to finding out the relationship between the input and output, you can say that. Okay, and if you change the input, so how much time the output is get changed, you have to find out that, and that you can find out using the gradient descent. Okay, so this is, you can say that the gradient descent. Okay, 1 minute. Okay, now the next. So the gradient descent is nothing but the simply measure the change in all the weight with range to the change in the error. Okay, so in this we have to just measure the changes in weightage. Okay, so what weight you require to change the output. So you want to find out you have to measure using the gradient. This thing, you can also think the gradient as a slope of a function. The higher the gradient, the sharper the slope, and faster the model can learn. Okay, so this is a way you can find out the gradient. This thing. Okay, so higher the gradient, it means that sharper the slope and faster the model can learn. Okay, so your model will be learned more faster if your gradient is higher. It represented by the sharper the slope. But if the slope is zero, if there is no slope, so model stop learning. So you can say that the model is not learning anything. Okay. In the mathematical term, the gradient is the partial derivative with respect to the input. Okay. So mathematically, we can say that the gradient is nothing but the partial derivative with respect to the input. So whatever the input you are giving, so as for that, your gradient will be a work. Now this is an formula, or you can say that equation to find out the gradient. This is the equation below describe what a gradient descent does. Okay, here we can find out the how the gradient descent is work. So B is the next position of our climbing. So what it is, B is indicating, this B is indicating that, this B is indicating that what will be the my next step. So how much I have to take a step to climb on the hill, and A is represent the current position, and A is represent my current position. So let us consider this is an hill position. Okay, got it. And currently I am at this position. Okay, so currently I am at this position, right? So this is indicating by the A. This is indicating by the A. Now, how much step I have to take to climb this hill? So I have to find out using this hill. So B is my question mark. B, I have to find out how much I have to take a step to climb on this hill. Okay. So how we can be find out? Then B is the next position of our climber, while A represents is the current position. The minus sign refers to minimization part of the gradient descent. So this minus refers to the minimization part of the gradient descent. The gamma, this one, the gamma in the middle is weighting factor, and the gradient term, that is this is a gradient term, is simply the direction of the steepest descent. Okay, out of this we know what is the value of A, because your current value, this is your current value where you are locating currently. Okay, so you can easily find out this current position, that okay, I am at the 1 feet, I am at the 3 feet, I am at the 4 feet from the bottom. Okay, from the bottom I am the 4 feet. So the value of A you know, value of A is you already know, and that you have to and this gamma, this gamma is nothing but the weighting factor. We will see what, how we can be find out that. Okay, this is a weighting factor, and this is a gradient term. Okay, this is nothing but the gradient term, and you can find out the direction of the secret in the descent. The goal of this gradient descent algorithm is to minimize the given function. What is the goal of this gradient descent? The goal of this gradient descent algorithm is to minimize the given function. To achieve this goal, it performs the two steps iteratively. Okay, so whenever you are using the gradient descent, so this gradient descent algorithm is used by the two steps. Which two steps? The first one is a compute the gradient. So first we have to find out the slope of your line. Okay, the slope of the line, that is at the nothing but the computing the gradient, the first order derivation of the function at that point, and next one is to make a step move in the direction position to the gradient. It means that opposite direction of the slope increase from the current point by alpha time the gradient at that point. Okay, so you can see that this is a diagram is representation. So on the x-axis I am keeping the weight, and the y-axis I am keeping the power. Okay, so this is nothing but the curve. Okay, and here you can get the minimum power, because here the slope of the line is zero. So this is a position where you can say that the slope of the line is near to zero. Okay, so you have to find out the gradient to the slope of the line. Okay, so this is your initial weight and these are indicating the step, incremental step. Now imagine you have a machine learning problem. So where do you use the gradient descent and how does this gradient descent is useful in machine learning? So that is the most important question. So let us consider I am using the one of the machine learning algorithms and I want to train your algorithm with a gradient descent to minimize the cost function. Okay, so we have to find out the minimum cost function, that is JWB, and reach its goal minimum by the tweaking its parameter, that is the W and the B. Right, so this is a representation of the gradient descent. So this cost function quantifies the error between the predicted value and expected value. So it is a quantifier error between the predicted value and the expected value and present it in the form of single real number. What is the ultimate goal of it? So this cost function is find out the error between the predicted value and the expected value. So what is the predicted value? The predicted value and the expected value we already seen in the y and y bar. Okay. So we have to find out the error between that predicted value and the expected value using the cost function. The image below shows the horizontal axis represents the parameter w and b, while the cost function w in bracket JB is represented on the vertical axis. And gradient descent is nothing but the covex function. So it is nothing but the covex function. We know that we want to find out the value of W and B and corresponding the minimum of the cost function, that is marked with a red arrow. So this is your minimum cost function. So this is the lowest part of your curve. Okay, so we can say that this is my lowest part of the curve because here the slope of the line is zero. Okay, so here we are getting the minimum cost of function, minimum cost function. To start finding the right value, we initialize the W and B with a some random value. So start, you must be starting your value. Okay, so to start finding the right value, we initialize this W and B value with a some random number. So you can choose any number for this W and B. So the gradient descent then starts at that point somewhere around the top of our interface. So let us consider your gradient descent will be start at the position, for example, this. So it started from this. Okay, this position at the top of the interface. And it takes one step after another in the steepest down side direction. Okay, so next it will go this, and it reaches, then it is reached, then it is reached, then here. Okay, so like this, it reaches up to this, and this is a smallest part. Okay, this is a smallest part of the loop. And from the top to the bottom of the illustration, until it reaches the point where the cost function is small as possible. Okay, so here your cost function is very small. At this position, your cost function is very small. Okay, so it is indicating your cost function, right? Now, for gradient descent, you have to reach to the local minimum to set the learning rate to an appropriate value, which is neither too low or nor too high. Okay, so here we have to reach the local minimum value. So what is the main important part of the gradient descent is that you have to reach the local minimum value, and this is important because if the steps are too big, it may not reach the local minimum because it bounces back and forth between the convex function of the gradient descent. See in the left side. So you can see that on this left side diagram. Okay. So if you are taking the big step, okay, so it may be bounce back. It may be a bounce back. So you can see that they are the first year algorithm is going this direction, then back to this, and then this, and then this. So this is a big learning rate. Okay, and if you set the learning rate to the very small value, so gradient descent will eventually reach the local minimum, but that may take a while. So
this is a right direction. So you cannot want this one and this one also. Okay. So how to make sure that your algorithm is working properly? So to find out the your machine learning algorithm correctness, you can use this gradient descent. So good way to make sure gradient descent run properly is by plotting the cost function as optimization run. So what I am doing here, I am using the x and y axis. So put the number of iteration on the x axis. So on the x axis direction, you can put the number of iteration and the value of the cost function on the y axis. So on the y axis, you can see that there is a cost function you are putting, and on the x axis, you are putting the number of iteration. This helps you to see the value of your cost function after each iteration of the gradient descent, and provide a way to easily plot how appropriate your learning rate is. Now you can just try the different value for it and plot them all together. The left image below show a plot, while the image on the right illustrates the difference between the good and the bad error rate. Okay, so this is a good one. On the left hand side, you can see that on the left hand side, you want such type of curve whenever you are working with a machine learning algorithm, for example, regression and the logistic regression on the cross-trained. So in that case, if your curve is getting like this, so this is a perfect algorithm. You can say that your algorithm is work properly. Otherwise, there are the few other where you can say that if you are getting the graph like this, so which is very high learning rate. So your algorithm is having the very high learning rate. If it is like this, this yellow line, blue line. So blue line is nothing but the low learning rate. This is indicating the low learning rate. And when this is a green, you can say that, and then it is a constant. Okay. So then there is no learning, high learning rate. Okay. So this is indicating the very high learning rate, This is indicating the very high, and this is indicating the low. But the best one is nothing but like this. So if you want to best find out the best one, so this is your best learning rate. So if you are getting such type of algorithm, so that you can say that your gradient descent is worked properly. Now here we use the gradient descent. So gradient descent are used in linear regression to optimize the point of intercept and the slope. And also it is used in the logistic regression to find out the sequel. Okay. So as you know that in this example, our aim is to find out this point of intercept. So which point of intercept is good when you are working with a linear regression. Okay. So you can either draw this such type of line, you can either draw such type of line. Okay, you can also draw this such type of line. You can also draw this line. You can also draw this line. So which line you can say that it is a perfect line? Okay, so this is depend on the point of intercept. So where your point, your line is get intercept, and what will be the slope of your line? So because these are the two input that you don't have to provide to your machine learning algorithm. Yes, you can provide the height of a person, you can provide the weight of a person, and you will get the height of a person. Okay, so from the weight you can find out the height of a person, but you are not providing the point of intercept. Okay, where your line will be get intercept with on the y axis, and this is the x axis, and also you cannot provide the slope of the line. So who will provide this point of intercept and the point of intercept of your line with the y axis? And how we can find out the slope of the line. So who will decide that? So to decide these two values, that is the point of intercept and the slope of the line, you can use the gradient descent. That is called the gradient descent. In this case, we are using the gradient descent to find out the point of intercept and the slope of the line. Okay. So this is all about the gradient descent. So in the next lecture, we will see the example how to implement the gradient descent.